You may have watched Pam and Tommy Lee's penis and said, "That is not Motley Crue." It's very astute of you. Hi, I'm Hurley. This is What the Fuck Happened to Methods of Mayhem. Methods of Mayhem was formed in 1999 by Tommy Lee, drummer of the legendary 80s metal band Motley Crue. Lee left Motley Crue for a while, and he decided he wanted to do some of that nu metal stuff all the kids were talking about. Lee had met Tilo Murray while Motley Crue was on tour with Headpiece. On a quick side note, I had no idea who this guy was, or how he was associated with Headpiece in any way. Missed it. With Tommy on vocals and rhythm guitar, Kia Marcus on lead, the rhythm section from Jane's Addiction, and Tilo to do all that rapping, Methods of Mayhem was finally ready to nu metal. What, you didn't like that? Together with his new crew, Tommy had some of the biggest names in music join him on the debut album. Fred Durst, Crystal Method, George Clinton, Snoop Dogg, Little Kim, Mixmaster Mike, Kid Rock, basically anybody who moved the needle in 1999. With sales driven by the single Get Naked, the album went gold within a month. And I'll be back with more after this.
I just took off my clothes and I had to do it!
Finally today in Los Angeles, Methods of Mayhem prepared to shoot their first video for Get Naked. And to everyone's great surprise, everyone in the video is naked!
$77 million made from watching me come under the sun on my vacation.
Baby, make it hot. Ride the cop till you hit the spot. Come on, baby, make it hot.
Doing it doggy style. Wow, 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 yippee-yo, yippee-yay. Bow, wow, yippee-yo, yippee-yay. Wow, 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 yippee-yo, yippee-yay. Bow, wow, yippee-yo, yippee-yo.
The little bitch, I hope I'm ducky. Yo, who thinks she can blow?
$1 love me long time in a limo. For really dough,
oh.
I'm just trying to fly with the flows. Freak up some hoes, blow up the shows. Make a little dough, as if you didn't know. Back to the strip club, freaking out some hoes. Swinging my ding-a-ling, that ain't no thing.
Hell yeah!
Nikki Six commented on the album saying, "It's good for what it is." You don't think that's a compliment? No? In September of 2000, Methods of Mayhem disbanded. Ah, but not for long. In 2009, Tommy announced the project would be revived with drummer Will Hunt, bassist Marty O'Brien, guitarist Phil X and J3, and DJ Arrow. The new incarnation of Methods of Mayhem was signed to Loud and Proud Records, and their album had features from Deadmau5, Skrillex, Chino, and Chad Kroeger. Because we don't get enough of his ass in Nickelback. The second album was not as successful as the first, only reaching 153 on the Billboard charts, despite the massive star power of Chad Kroeger. Tilo Murray decided not to come back for the second album, instead deciding to focus on his new project, Fusion NDX. The project was reported to feature the rapper Roscoe, Chester Bennington, and Sid and Clown from Slipknot. Right? Sounds crazy. Other than a few random references online, we didn't find anything else about this project, so we assume it didn't go anywhere. In 2019, Tommy Lee announced that Methods of Mayhem was going to be resuscitated once more. But since that announcement, there has been no further news. While some may argue that Tommy Lee's attempt at the nu metal genre is disingenuous like others who have tried their hand at it, yes. Yes, it's on the list. While others would argue that attempting nu metal is the ultimate sin. But however you feel about Methods of Mayhem, they are part of the history of metal, whether you hate them or not. Please hit like, hit subscribe if you're not a subscriber, and thank you to those of you who already are. If you enjoy our content and you're in a position to help the channel grow, please join our Patreon at patreon.com/retromusicreview. Did you listen to Methods of Mayhem? I didn't, but apparently a lot of you did if it went gold. Did you know Tilo was in Head P? I had no fucking idea who this guy was. What are some of the worst things to come out of nu metal? Whoa, not everyone all at once. And yes, it's on the list.
Red 6-3.